We've actually had the founder of Keyball Games on Future Perfect several years back, Barry Silvestri.
Yes.
How's he doing now?
He's doing great. He's working on some stuff.
And some of the stuff, of course, coming out of Keyball Games, Jackaxe and Grand Guilds.
Yes.
Tell us the background of how these came about. Let's start with, what is it, Jackaxe?
Jackaxe.
Which one did you have a Kickstarter campaign?
It was Grand Guilds. Grand Guilds is the one that we're publishing. So it's made by a studio based in Naga by Drick Studios.
Drick Studios. And so the owner of Drick Studios is?
Justin. Yeah.
And his full name is Justin Hendricks Villegas, ergo Drick Studios.
Drick, okay.
So he's based in Naga.
Yeah, he is.
Okay.
So they're very talented, actually. We showcased the game in PAX East and in GDC in San Francisco and Boston. It had really good reception. People were they were enjoying it. And they were like, oh, this is a game I would play.
Describe what the game is about.
It's a tactical RPG game. And it's about a guild that is trying to save something, you know.
So. I guess it's like a magical guild?
Yes, it's a magical guild. So, okay. Of course, they have powers and they're trying to fight off this force that's like messing up some things.
I feel like you're hesitant to give me the entire storyline because there might be spoilers in what you're describing.
Yes, of course. So
you have to
play the game to
What's the synopsis of the game? So it's a guild. How many characters are in the guild?
Nine.
Nine characters.
Nine,
so you can choose from nine characters?
Yes.
Okay.
So it starts off with one, Eliza. It's the beginning. Actually, you can play the demo on our Kickstarter campaign. So if anyone wants to see what the first part is about, you can just check it out on our Kickstarter campaign.
Okay, and there are cards in the game, I guess?
Yes. Yeah. So instead of just the usual way wherein you have these, like, powers. I'm sorry, I'm not really like a gamer, but instead
you're
of
not
just...
a gamer.
I'm not a gamer.
But you're a game developer.
I'm not the game developer. I'm the business developer.
Oh,
so I just kind of like do the things that the CEO doesn't want to do. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah.
Yes, Barry, you're paying Thea a lot to do that for you.
Yeah.
All right. So Grand Guilds, you had a Kickstarter campaign. When did that start and how much have you raised so far?
It started on April 9. So it ends on May 10.
Okay.
And we are around 175% funded. So our goal was 12,000 and we're at 21.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we reached our goal in 24 hours. Oh no, around 36.
Yeah.
More than a day, less than 2 days.
Well, what do you ascribe, you know, the enthusiastic support that you've gotten from Kickstarter for Grand Guilds?
What do you mean, like?
I mean, why do you think a lot of people actually funded or contributed to the Kickstarter campaign?
It's interesting. It's fun. It has really beautiful art. Aside from that, it's unique in the way that it's card-based. So it's not just the usual way it is.
Yeah. And you know, given that, you know, a Filipino developer also made Grand Guilds, it's fascinating that the artwork itself, the animation, is very sleek.
Yeah, it is.
How long did it take to develop Grand Guilds?
I know it's been in development for a couple years. So we met Drick's guys and we thought we can help you out, let's team up on this. So we started publishing their games, and that's also something that we want to do. We want to help other Filipino game developers that, you know, it's hard to get out there and find publishers, especially since we're in Asia. We're not in Singapore, so it's a little more challenging to find people who want to publish your game.
I think Thea, maybe a little bit of a background if you can provide us. Not a lot of people are familiar with how the game development industry in the Philippines is currently operating.
Yeah.
And right now, Keyball is actually a game developer.
Yes.
But you're also publishing other people's games that are developed, like, say, by Drick.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So how does that work?
So in November 2018, we got granted a publisher account by Nintendo, which means we can make games and sort of upload it onto the Switch platform.
Okay, and this is the Switch.
That's the Switch.
Right here.
Yes.
You brought a Switch. What did you load on it?
This is Jackaxe.
Jackaxe. Okay, not Jackass.
Jackaxe.
It's Jackaxe.
Yeah.
I said that.
Jackaxe.
So you're now a publisher as well, meaning to say you can get other game developers to develop the game software,
and
you'll be the one to actually upload it to a platform.
Yes.
So is Grand Guilds also, of course, on Nintendo Switch?
Yes.
Yeah. And other platforms,
it's going to be on PC as well. So Steam.
A PC game as well.
And Steam. We plan on releasing it onto other platforms in the future.
And Jack-Ax, okay, which is a really difficult not to mispronounce. Jack-Ax. It actually was awarded, I think, in a game show?
In like Malaysia. A game contest? Yeah, we were nominated. We were nominated in October 2018 for one of the games, but we didn't win the award. It's okay, but
learned a lot. But it was a finalist.
Yes.
One of the finalists.
So we got a free booth. So we got to showcase it, and then a lot of people were playing. They enjoyed it.
Okay. And Jack-Ax is developed by Keyball itself?
Yes. Oh, so Mike Reneville. And the artwork is done by other people in our team, Natasha.
So this is in-house?
This
is not developed
in-house.
By any other game development center.
It's in-house.
So basically, what is Jack-Ax about?
So it's about a girl. So if you play the... Should I?
That's okay. We're showing it on the screen, right?
Okay. So it's about a girl who's trying to find out where all the men went. Yeah.
Okay. So it's like you find yourself in Tinder limbo.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Something
you're a girl
like that.
You can't find any men. Okay. Yeah. So you're in Tinder limbo. All right. So fantastic.
But it's actually about four sisters. So if you play the one person part version, it's about a girl who's trying to find out where all the men went, and she has this axe. And women back in that day, so like in the Viking era, you're not allowed to carry weapons.
Okay.
But she had no choice but to hold the weapon.
Because there are no guys left.
Yeah, so she had to save the day.
And is then she Jack?
She's Jack, and she has sisters named Jack. So they're like J-A-C-K, J-A-Q-U-E, just a whole bunch of Jacks, and they have an axe. Yeah.
This really calls for a lot of puns, which I will not divulge tonight. So Jack-Ax is really a side-scrolling game.
It's a platformer.
And it's a platformer, all right. And how soon will that be released on the Nintendo Switch?
We're targeting third quarter of 2019, so around September, August, September, maybe October. Yeah.
Okay.